What's good, everyone? Thank you for stopping by to visit the channel for this upcoming game preview. If you want to stay updated with the latest news of the college football world, click that subscribe button, click the notification bell, and select all so you won't miss another video. It has been 8 long months, but it's finally here. We're in week 0 and we're kicking off the college football season with a clash in the state of Florida between the 8th ranked Florida Gators and the Miami Hurricanes. Both teams are fielding impressive defenses and rebuilding offensive lines. Usually I would have advanced metrics for you to look at, but since it's not out yet, let's take a look at the season review for both teams. Dan Mullen is one of the best offensive coaches in the country. The Gators in the previous years were not proficient in that aspect, but in 1 year he turned the Gators from having an offense ranked 108th in offensive S&P Plus in 2017 to 21st in 2018. Part of that was utilizing the strengths of quarterback Felipe Franks and calling plays that best fit his skill set. It also didn't hurt to have a talented wide receiver group in Ole Miss transfer Van Jefferson and Josh Hammond, who combined for 872 yards and 10 touchdowns. He'll also have Trevon Grimes, who is a former top 100 recruit and Ohio State transfer, and Freddie Swain, who returns as their best route runner. Jacob Copeland is another top 100 guy, and he will have increased impact in his second year. He won't have Jordan Scarlett to hand the ball off to anymore, but LaMichael P. Ryan is no slouch at running back, and before I forget, neither is Kadarius Toney, who is used as a Percy Harvin type player. On defense, defensive coordinator Ty Grantham turned the Florida defense from solid to stout. The man believes in blitzing now, blitzing later, blitzing some more, and when you least expect it, he'll bring another blitz. There is no telling where this team would have been if they didn't lose studs in Ja'Kai Polite, Vosan Joseph, and Chauncey Gardner-Johnson to the NFL, but the Gators still return 71% of their production on defense. Gardner-Johnson's leadership will be missed, but there may not be much of a letdown in the secondary. The Canes had high expectations last year after an Orange Bowl appearance in 2017. That year it felt like the 80s in the old Orange Bowl with the nod to the throwback uniforms. It felt like the program, simply known as the U, was back, but once they lost the pit on the road, it looked as though their psyche was crushed. Something was missing from them as they proceeded to lose the remaining two games against Clemson and Wisconsin, and started their season opener against LSU the following year with a loss. They hired their defensive coordinator Manny Diaz, who had a cup of coffee at Temple for a little over 2 weeks, and he made a shrewd hire as soon as he landed in Coral Gables in making former Alabama quarterback coach Dan Enos as his offensive coordinator. Enos is arguably one of, if not, the best at maximizing the potential of his quarterbacks. I have been a believer in him ever since he sent Brandon Allen from Arkansas to the NFL to collect a check. He has Jaren Williams this year as his QB1, and he is the best pure passer of the quarterback group. But I believe this is going to be an offense that will get better as the season goes on. Now, Manny Diaz might be the head coach, but he's going to have his fingerprints on the defense. He brought in Blake Baker from Louisiana Tech, who hails from the Diaz coaching tree. Baker took a Louisiana Tech defense round 80th in defensive S&P Plus in 2015 to a top 50 ranking last year. Since he is from the Diaz coaching tree, this means it is going to be an aggressive defensive scheme, but Baker is going to have some darn good talent to work with. Bubba Bolden from USC and Trevon Hill from Virginia Tech came from the transfer portal, and they are expected to have an immediate impact on the field. John Garvin is a potential first-day draft pick, and Shaq Quarterman and Michael Pinckney returned for their final season. They have some dudes on that side of the ball. The keys to the game are simple for both teams. For Florida, they have to stay composed against Miami's aggressive defense, and for Miami, they gotta be able to tackle in space very well against Florida's wide receivers, since they love to have their quarterbacks on the island and play in press man coverage. But if we're really being honest with ourselves, for both teams, they are breaking in new offensive lines. The offensive line that gets the most push and allows the least amount of disruption from the opposing front seven will win the game, in my opinion. Both teams are returning one full-time starter in their respective offensive lines, and this is going to be a tough game to start for either team. The spread has Florida as a 7-point favorite. That tells me that Vegas knows something that I don't know. A top 10 team that is a single-point favorite over an unranked team is something that will raise an eyebrow. I really love Miami's experience and the transfers they brought in on defense. I think their offense will be good late this season, but I am picking the Gators in this one, due to having more pieces around them offensively, and Felipe Franks' progression in the Mullen system. I believe he'll run for a few first downs, and that will be key in this game. I have the Gators winning this one to the score of 24-14. And that will be a wrap for this game preview. Let me know what your thoughts are on the game in the comments section below. Give me your score prediction and also tell me why your respective team is going to win the game. I hope you enjoyed the video. All I ask is that you give the video a like. And if you love college football as much as I do, hit that subscribe button if you want to stay updated with the latest previews and the occasional highlights. Until next time, thank you for watching.